I'm Bob Dean. I represent Mondial Rides, and we have been involved together for 12, 13 years, and my company represents their business interest in North and South America. You would call them really the high-end flat ride provider in the world, but so many of these rides aren't flat anymore that it's really difficult to call them that. And I call it flat and high-rising rides. And it's really that genre of big steel. It doesn't look like other rides, it doesn't sound like other rides, it's just bigger. And they've really taken the lead in that particular category of ride probably about 10 or 11 years ago, and have been rolling with that same kind of momentum. At Knott's Berry Farm, they looked at several options for the old Windseeker site, and what they've decided to do was take our original top scan, which they own in their Canadian park, and supersize it a little bit, so it's a little bit different, a bit more capacity on the ride, and drop that into the old Windseeker site by use of this very clever and innovative base plate, which will interface between that old Windseeker foundation and the new ride structure, and really just kind of fit down right on the old anchor bolts. It's really quite clever, and it's going to be a great ride. Blender is a combination of quite a few things that we do already. We've taken the uneven arms of, you know, the look of Splash Over, like the old Top Spin rides, some of us, but the uneven nature of those rides, like the Walkie Key Wave and our rollover ride. And we've combined it with our circular gondolas, like on a lot of our swing rides, Jet Force and Ultramax, Revolution. And now it is really kind of a hybrid between those two rides. Instead of this linear gondola, like we would on a Splash Over or a Top Spin, we have circular gondolas that are spinning on the same type of bar. And it's really taking it's a prototype, but it's taking things we've already done and combining them in a different way. We have a portfolio that stretches between 48 and 54 inch rider heights. And you ride some of these 54 inch rider heights and it's wild. I mean, these are wild, highly dynamic rides. Probably some of the most dynamic rides in the entire industry. You don't ever want to jinx anything, but the track record of these rides and really the way they approach this, it is truly a high-end supplier here. It's not just somebody that's assembled rides for a while. Very buttoned up, quality control very, very tight, and almost everything TUV, either compliant or TUV ready. And so, like I said, you don't want to jinx things, but the history has been quite good. The ride we introduced here at the show and our latest point of focus, we have several ideas and we're always kind of working on these ideas in an abstract way, and we'll take them out to our customers and say, what do you think? And you know, some of those make the cut, some don't. This particular ride made the cut, and it's called Blender, that same Blender ride. There are four other concepts that we're kind of working on right now with buyers and customers out there, but nothing I can talk about at this time. Well, Cedar Fair is trusting us with another ride for their Canadian park. That's an Inferno ride. And Inferno's really, as far as the traditional portfolio, Inferno's my favorite ride in the whole portfolio. It's big, it's very thrilling, and it doesn't look like anything else anywhere. And in North America, that's it for the coming year, those two rides. But we're busy elsewhere. We're busy in the Middle East. We're setting a Splash Over ride, which is our split gondola. I think you guys know what, there's one in Canada right now, but that's going to a project in Doha. And that deal was done here domestically with the help of International Theme Park here out of Cincinnati. The wheel business for Mondial has exploded now. I think we're in the midst of three or four giant wheels. We have a giant wheel coming to the States, our first Mondial wheel coming to the States, that is part of their portable or transportable category of giant wheel that has really kind of changed the whole dynamic of the wheel business, with a 50, you know, 60, even a larger wheel, being able to take that wheel from place to place rather than take that risk of one particular location and really not being able to easily move the wheel if that location doesn't work out so well. So we're very busy here. All this is coming in next year and in future years, but we're very busy here.